Hello, today we try to put an IV according exactly to the hygienic standards of our hospital. Before we approach the patient, let's organize a treatment cart or tray with non-sterile gloves, a bed protector, a hand disinfectant solution, the appropriate catheters, an aseptic skin disinfectant solution, a tourniquet, sterile IV catheter dressing, an additional fixation, compresses 5 × 5 cm, a needle box, a garbage can or sack, and a surface disinfectant. Last but not least, let's prepare an infusion or a needle-free IV connector with one normal saline syringe. Inform the patient as first, then if not already done, we will install it on a lounger, a bed or a chair. We put a bed protection under the puncturing extremity. If we already have to touch the patient here, we will do a hand disinfection before. As a fourth point, we would wear safety goggles if there is a risk of splashing into the eyes. As a fifth point, we perform a hand disinfection. Then we put the tourniquet on. We locate the puncture site. As point 8, we release the tourniquet. If necessary, we shave down the puncture point. After that, we carry out again a hygienic hand disinfection. As point 10, we prepare aseptically the required utensils for the veni puncture. As point 11, we soak the compresses in the packaging with the antiseptic solution. Point 12, we disinfect the puncture area thoroughly according to the screw technique and 3 times with different compresses. We respect the exposure time of the antiseptic and make sure not to touch the puncture area again. We put the tourniquet on again. We perform a hand disinfection and pull the gloves on. We now insert the catheter. Here we have to stop the process because the patient complains about sensory disturbances in the thumb. The strong twitching after the puncture also indicates the touch of a nerve. It probably touched the superficial branch of the radial nerve, which is located along the vena sephenica. In case of a failure, we start again at point 5. Point 16, we reinsert the catheter, and once the puncture of the vein has been successful, the reflex chamber fills with blood. Now you should insert the catheter another millimeter so that also the plastic catheter is safe in the vein. This was unfortunately not done here. The reintroduction of the needle shown here is prohibited due to the risk of piercing the catheter. After the renewed advancement of the catheter, the vein will stick through. The result is a hematoma formation. This process must be aborted. After a second failure, if possible, let another person try here. This starts again at point 5. the third puncture attempt succeeds, the cannula can be pushed right down. We release the tourniquet again. We fix the catheter with the sterile tape of the catheter dressing. As point 19, we would have to cover the puncture site with the transparent dressing. Budding disc was skipped here. As point 20, we put a sterile compress under the catheter. We compress the vein at the catheter end. We remove the introducer needle while holding the catheter firmly. Then we dispose the needle directly into the needle box. Point 24, we screw up the infusion. Point 25, remove the sterile compress. With a little delay, the transparent dressing is placed. This allows the observation of the puncture point. Point 26, we provide a secure catheter fixation, as here with an additional adhesive strip or a splint or a bandage. We dispose of all waste, take off the gloves and dispose of them too. Thereafter, we again perform a hand disinfection. We inform the patient about any signs of complications and that he needs to inform the nursing staff in case immediately. Last but not least, we document our measures in the medical file as far as our standard practice to start an IV. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you and goodbye. Until next time.